Students, welcome to biology lecture. In the previous lecture, we have discussed regarding the linkage and crossing over, as well as some part of the mutation. Today we'll continue mutation. Let us see what are mutations. We already know mutation is a sudden change in the structure of chromosome. These are of two types. The first is gene mutation and chromosomal mutation. What are gene mutation? Why they are called point mutation also? Because a gene mutation changes the nucleotide sequence of the DNA molecule. Here we can say of a particular locus on the chromosome. That's why it is called point mutation. They can be dominant, they can be recessive, they can be lethal also. Lethal means harmful. These mutation can be harmless also, sex linked also, or they can be on autosome chromosomes also. Now what are chromosomal mutation? They are nothing but change in the number or structure of the chromosome is called chromosomal mutation. They may occur during prophase 1 of meiosis. Why? Because if you remember, during anaphase, when chromosomes are aparting, at that time they can be plus or minus. And we have studied these types of chromosomal aberration. So this is the example of chromosomal mutation. Now this mutation are of two types in nature and by man. First is called spontaneous mutation. Spontaneous mutations are present in nature, they are randomly and they are seen at a very low rate. What is induced mutation? Induced mutation is done by some agents, we call them as mutagens. They are present at a very high rate also. And what are mutagen examples are usually asked in exam. So please learn this mustard gas, sodium azide, as well as X-rays, gamma rays, UV rays, cosmic radiation, all are mutagens which may cause mutation. We will see some of the examples of mutation now. First is frame shift mutation. In frame shift mutation, it is done because of insertion, that is putting in, or deletion or removing of a single base in a DNA sequence or a gene. Suppose this is a triplet code on the DNA. This triplet code can be disturbed, and let us see how it can be disturbed. Suppose it is disturbed by inserting cytosine C nitrogen base. So here CAT was a triplet code, and if suppose C is added here, T will be shifted. So now instead of CAT, it is CCA and T has been shifted here. Same way the G has been shifted and whole of the chain is now modified or changed. The second case of frame shift is deletion, that is removing of the thymine nitrogen base T. So this T has been removed. You can see it is out. When this is out, then AG will take the A over here. So AGA, and this is how whole DNA sequence will change. So this brings the change in the character of organism. Next topic we are going to see is changes in the number of chromosomes. According to this also, there are two types of mutations. First is called euploidy. In euploidy, there can be addition or loss of one set of chromosome. It can be one or more than one set in a diploid organism. What is one set? One set means 23 number of chromosome. Suppose there is a loss of one set of chromosome and they have only now n number of chromosome, that is half number of chromosome. Such type of condition is called monoploidy. Suppose there is an addition of one or more sets of chromosome in a diploid organism, then such a condition is called polyploidy. Suppose in a 2n diploid condition, 1n is added, it becomes 3n. In 2n, suppose 2 sets are added, it becomes 4, and so on. So this is called triploidy, tetraploidy, pentaploidy, hexaploidy. Next is aneuploidy. Here there is addition or loss of one chromosome in haploid genome or gametes. So you know gametes have 23 chromosomes, and if there is addition it can be 24, if there is minus it can be 22 only. Such a condition is called aneuploidy, and if there is loss it is called hyperploidy. If there is addition in the gamete, the chromosome, it is called hyperploidy. Now related to mutation, we have seen the mutation brings disorders usually. We are going to see some of the examples under the heading called genetic disorders. You know what are autosomes? So we are going to see some defects in autosome due to mutation. So autosome linked recessively inheritance. The best example is sickle cell anemia. This sickle cell anemia, what is it? There is one gene present on 11th chromosome which controls the shape of the RBC. If this particular gene is disturbed or is absent or is faulty, then RBC shape is changed into sickle shape, and so the name is given sickle cell anemia. Let us see with the example. There is a gene which controls, so let us see its alleles. There is HbA, which is normal hemoglobin RBC. There is HbS, which is sickle cell mutant gene. If the heterozygous condition or carrier parents are crossed, you can see S is there in both of them, you will get F1, the four conditions. In this four condition, HbA is a normal, so 25%. These will be, you know, both hetero condition, so 50% will be sickle cell carrier and they will have mild anemia. But the last one, offspring, both S are present, such a condition is called sickle cell anemia, which is very lethal and harmful, and this child may die very soon. Why this has happened? This has happened because of the substitution of glutamic acid, this is an amino acid, by valine in the sixth position of the beta globin chain of hemoglobin. Due to this, biconcave disc shape of RBC is changed into sickle shape RBC. The next example is thalassemia. Human hemoglobin is made up of two alpha globin chain and two beta globin chain. We were discussing about the thalassemia. In thalassemia, usually what happens, it is blood disorder. We know that human hemoglobin is made up of two alpha globin chain and two beta globin chain. Do remember that two alpha globin chain are controlled by two genes, HbA1, HbA2, and two beta globin chain is controlled by one pair of the gene, HBB. Now let us see. Here there are four genes, two of this and two of another gene. If suppose HbA is defective, so alpha globin chain will not be synthesized because it is defective gene here. In that case, this HbA2 will be synthesized more and more and will become excess. Inside the RBC, it will create problem and RBC will get destroyed. And now the person will suffer with anemia. Now let us see, if both of them are destroyed, then beta chain will be synthesized in excess and it will create an unstable compound called tetramer HBH, and
it will create problem. Here there are two conditions. Condition number one,
beta thalassemia minor. In this case, there are two genes, you know, one pair of genes. Suppose I have shown red is defective, one is normal. In this case, they will have small RBCs, they will have mild anemia, and they will be carrier of beta thalassemia. If suppose both the genes are defective, shown by the red, then what will happen? They will suffer with the Cooley's anemia. This is visible from 6 to 12 months of a child, and this is called severe anemia. They need continuous transfusion of the blood, otherwise the child may die. We can also explain with this.
Suppose there are four genes, you know, alpha chain is controlled by four genes. Red is shown faulty. If one is faulty, then they are silent carrier. No problem in them. They will have small RBC, mild anemia they will suffer, and it can mild anemia. The second case, suppose two genes are defective. They will have small RBCs, mild anemia, and they can be detected by blood test also. Third case, if three genes are defective from four, then the person will suffer lifelong anemia. Then blood transfusion is necessary for them. Hemoglobin H disease it is called, and so symbolized by HbH. Fourth case, if all the genes are defective, then what will happen? They will not survive. It is long lasting anemia, and this is called Hb Bars Hydrops Fetalis. So this was regarding the thalassemia. We have to explain this condition. Next is sex-linked disease. That is the disease present on X or Y chromosome. We have to study color blindness and hemophilia here. Now, what is color blindness? You know, the person cannot detect red and green color if they are kept together. When XX are having the color blind gene, the daughter is color blind. If one X is only having the color blind gene, the daughters are carrier and they are normal. If son is having one X color blind gene, then son is color blind. So this you can explain with the help of Punnett square.
Next disease is hemophilia. Hemophilia, in this factor 8, which is necessary for blood clotting, is absent. This is recessive allele present on the X chromosome. It is related to X chromosome. So this hemophilia is similar disease. I have not shown the condition are similar to this. Next is autosomal disorder. This example you should know, Down syndrome. In this Down syndrome, 21st chromosome is not pair, but it is having one extra chromosome, so it is called trisomy. Here you have to write five symptoms of the Down syndrome child which is born, like moon shape, face, tongue protruding, mental retarded, etc. Then comes next example of sex chromosome disorders are Klinefelter syndrome. In this syndrome, male is having one extra X, and total number of the chromosomes will be 47. Here also you have to learn five symptoms, like they will have all the feminine character. Next is Turner syndrome. In this, one X is absent in the female, in the sex chromosome. So what is the total number of chromosome? One is less, so it will be 45 chromosome. Here also you have to write 5 to 6 characters, like the pinpoint is they have webbed neck, sterile reproductive organs, mental retarded, etc. By this topic, we complete chapter 7. So prepare well and have a nice day.